it's the Keen problem.
Yeah.
This contagion. There, it is.
Yeah, it really is. It really is.
And also, he's able to just straight up hard farm, get himself towards the mid game that he's comfortable with, grab his first item, things like at least even in farm, but I guess that's a whole wave behind technically, is Sword. Electrocute going to be put to good use here as World Ender is just negated. It's now Dove is being looked for. That's an empowered shock blast. And Tarzan says, get back here. As Griffin move over, Summit should be able to get to position.
Wait, Summit's dead now.
Well, unless he can get himself some stuns, because of course that does damage to minions now. But in the meantime, the bottom out of Tara fell.
Yeah. Viper down.
Needs to be careful though. They're reacting to this Zoe in this mid game very, very well. Over on the side of Griffin, Sword looking for his flank opportunity as the cask is not the one that you want. Is now Sword maybe in a little bit early. Ragnarok coming down, goes golden, does the Aatrox as Tarzan locks down the first Cloud Drake. Sword in trouble, he's going to go down first as Root grabs it. Summit, gigantic damage into the backline as Dove looking for Viper, portal jump.
This most likely going to also...
haven't seen Tom Kench's original skin for a really long time. I feel like Tom Kench, you know, MasterChef is like really popular, as well as his cool Lunar New Year skin as well.
It's been a while since he's left the house.
That's true.
So
forgot to get changed, man, because Senna is right there with Piercing Darkness to immediately give a big.
One was with the low ground sword, doing his best effort to die here.
Well, the Abyssal Voyage should certainly help that one out, as we got four onto one, and that is not odds that I would so. Cloud Soul now invested. Sandbox squad, not going to have to worry about
it. He seems to have forgotten about the Abyssal Voyage, or just had a lapse of judgment with how far up he was.
Yeah, it's majestic.
Definitely
majestic.
Like, it's a legendary Pokemon in real life.
Yep. They don't have those fishing options outside of Yukal softening people up with these Shock Blasts, as we can see.
Nice.
A little bit aggressive there.
I love the bubble's
going to go wide.
That's
a great stopwatch, but it might be the end of your life. Flash has to be used as Viper. Very, very low, but on Fleek, he falls. Dawning Shadow interrupted by Death. That is the best CC in the game. And now Root just kiting the Aatrox out. He's an afterthought being
the Elder Dragon.
Yeah, they could be killing it right now.
They could be killing it right now. Braum could go over. Cast. What is
the Elder Dragon?
No.
Gonna hang out as here's Dove, the taking a bit of damage there, but we're still going for a 50-50. Man. Can Sandbox effectively turn onto Tarzan as they think, nope, they don't even need to worry about it. Body Slam gets him out. And now we've got Baron, we've got Elder. Onfleek doesn't have much of a health bar, but he's got a GA. We're wanting to structure their team fights was just impossible because Sword didn't last long enough. When he was bouncing for a little while, Summit, like you were saying, part of the one. Still very, very strong. Doesn't have to, didn't have to use the Slicing Maelstrom in around the Elder Drake, so still has that threatened, still has Flash, and still has Stopwatch as well. You can feel it. He's feeling antsy right now. I even thought maybe that that was the time, but first inhibitor goes down, second will be soon to follow. So I don't think Sandbox need to worry about spending time top lane. 3-0 and 2 certainly ain't a bad way to do it.
But they're sick. Huh. You ever noticed that?
Maybe that's a rounding thing. Well, that's very dead wrong. That's one of those fishing moments that we were talking about. Tarzan gets discovered, I believe, on a sweeper. There's the undertow that's been making all the decisions, making all the moves. And even when they're left open, it's an issue. As Summit goes in, I think there was a center there. Not entirely sure because she's gone now. And these Nexus turrets are going to follow suit. The Nexus dies extraordinarily quickly. And that will be that. 3-9 is the kill score. The game lasted a very long time.
Well.
All right. Varus is locked.
Could be Aphelios top lane. We've seen the Shy actually play that a lot.
3 and level 4.
They're going to crash and... yeah, okay. Zoe is not long for the world.
Well, Exhaust comes out onto Yukal. There's the dredge line. It lands. Can they actually get the aggro to work? And yes, they can. Yukal picks it up, takes one shot. Not exactly what you want. On the sword's side because he had to move.
Oh, man.
A different showing as Tarzan in a whole host of trouble does get the culling across the top of him, but there's the Dawning Shadow Summit. Will be the sacrifice, but Sandbox are now here to get it. Can scale a little bit more reliably into the late game.
I think, Sir Thomas.
Oh, he's being baited. But we get in here. That's a great barrel to come down. But the Flash is actually going to get into range as Summit. He's alive for so long. Joker just eats him up, pops him out, and Dove's going to grab that kill onto the Nautilus. Sick out. And Viper even able to stack up the Crescendum on the turret. Seems to always have Crescendum and Severum. And it had to actually waste his little bit. By the time spent in the sky, he's going to be able to make it out. But Flash utilized. The turret that we were talking about does fall down as Piercing Darkness comes in, but the Moonlight Vigil and everything else is going to Vision. But otherwise, this is Griffin taking care of business, but Sandbox's attention entirely damage there.
What?
Oh, what was Okay. I need to try and use the explosive cast to clear out that wave just to force an extra wave and mean that Summit has extra use, but Summit doesn't care. Just trying to deter Sword from being able to do anything. Onfleet comes on over. Does have Flash available, and oh no. Body Slam still up. That's a very dead Sword, and Summit just grabs that kill. Didn't even change clothes between games. No, we thought that he was unprepared.
Okay. Oh, did you see the 10.4 update?
No, I haven't seen that yet, but I heard about it as Yukal is in a heck of a lot of trouble. That's the Flash Body Slam, but Yukal's going to Flash as well. In comes Sword, but the Flash out from Joker should be able to get him to relative safety. Eats his Grey Health, the Moonlight Vigil comes in, but very nicely. Dawning Shadow very close to being available, so Irogue will need to get out of here. As another bubble lands, this time Sword can't follow up, but Joker, he's going to be dead. Irogue going to be traded, so no more supports on this map. Onfleek was off this vision.
And right now, Griffin, they're on such the back
foot. Oh my god, Yukal just being torn apart. Dawning Shadow gets stopwatched there by Tarzan and gets turned around. Viper finds himself, but Root able to take down Sword, and now there's such low health bars. Onfleek, that's going to go down very quickly.
And so Zoe, right now 106, ended up getting 6 armor.
Not bad.
And so...
And that's a Zoe. She's got an arm guard, I guess. So
yeah.
Not too bad. Okay, Chains of Corruption land. There's the Moonlight Vigil as well as the Dawning Shadow to keep Joker alive. Comes in. Sword parks himself right in the middle of the situation and gets booped back by the barrel. And now the culling, you know everyone there, and you're like, you make this really weird entrance.
Or but actually... To provide that much value against this Drake in particular.
Well, there we go again, but the bubble was placed down right on top of Sword's feet, and he is straight up dead. Dawning Shadow flies.
Yeah, I mean, I wasn't expecting the Sword
to come out of this
either.
Sword Jenkins. Around there, utilizing Abyssal Voyage nicely as the bubbles fly through. This is exactly where Sandbox wants to be fighting. Alright, Moonlight Vigil does come in.
That's
so
a lot of
damage. Comes down the Calibrum. Devour utilized there, but in goes Sword from the backside. Senna already dead. Joker probably going to follow. As now the turn onto Onfleek is there. Viper going to lock that one down as Sword probably will fall down. Here's a flash forward from Summon.
No.
What was that? Just rush of blood to the head? Is that... I don't know. The Aphelios is going to be taken down.
You want to have these conversations again.
Well, Moonlight Vigil says no. It does decorate. We've got Calibrum. It is in there as Sword. Actually, it's going to get moved towards the Gragas, and that is Jungler now down.
The lead is still there, honestly, for Sandbox.
But it may not be there for too much longer as Irope has found Joker. Oh no, Summit
culls
in from the side. A lot of damage now, as remember. Doesn't have Flash, but Viper has to go golden. No more DPS for that Crescendum, and he's immediately dead. Tarzan comes over. They do manage to take down
back home, so they're going to be able to get themselves an inner turret alongside it. Yukal's walking back, and Tarzan desperately wants to be able to...
They need to burst this down, but Tarzan doesn't have Smite.
Oh, yeah, Tarzan doesn't, but Onfleek does, and he's able to secure it. Even if Summit falls down here. Also, Sandbox aren't going to let them, right?
They've got four members Iroh here. Going for a flank.
Flanking Nautilus. It's not exactly Vladimir, but it ain't bad. As the man drop does come over the top. Oh, he finds the center out of nowhere. As Root with the Piercing Darkness actually just flashes over the top. Gets himself the ult, as now Iroh does have the Gargoyle Stone Plate, but he gets snared up by center. This is the power of this damn champion. Finally, we're witnessing it in the LCK, as Root will go down immediately after I say that.
Joker,
can you lick them to death is the question, as Aphelios was trying to do the work, but didn't quite manage to. The bubble goes wide, and Yukal gets it with the piercing arrow.
Well, just for attack speed,
I guess
but
you
it
have a bit
options.
Of extra, yeah. And Yukal's having a great game, so I can't really fault him for it. Viper, though, he's down to basically no health as the man drop
Going to be Zhonya, there by Onfleek. Sword having to flash. Moonlight Vigil runes able to lock down that kill.
Yeah.
And so it's a really weird thing.
Oh no, that's a face check. That ain't a great one there as Onfleek doesn't find the body slam, but they will be able to claim Iroh pretty quickly in this fight. Viper finds his way out the back though, and now it's only Joker and Onfleek in here. Double kill comes forward. Yukal finds himself another one, and I'm never saying bad things about Lethal Tempo Lethality Varus, because Yukal is currently 8-0-12, hard carrying this game.
Oh, and
good sidestep.
If the tongue lash had hit, I'm actually curious if Tom could have. I think Tom can actually kill him. Yeah, Tom can kill him with a little bit more.
I'm never saying anything about a player ever again.
Tom can kill him.
He might just die to the minions, man.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Jokers is going to go home and let them do it. What is this? But
wait,
he's going home to a base that's being absolutely destroyed, and no one's going to be available. So we are going to a game number three, ladies and gentlemen. Griffin tie up the series on the back of an undying. And the Diana's going into the jungle. We don't know. Likely that you're not going to put a Zac anywhere other than into vision. Summit now with a slight disadvantage, a supreme display of talent onto Dove. Iroh is here, but the Devourer from Joker is also. There's the flash out. Dove actually with the Moonfall does a fair bit of work, but in the end unable to make it happen, and Sandbox are getting corralled. Root is going to get here. Crescendum is armed. Does in fact have the Infernum alongside it as well, and finally Severum is what's going to come forward. But with Root at full health, Onfleek very, very low. Summit now chasing after Viper as the Abyssal Voyage is going to bring the Aphelios towards the bottom side, but Viper does get to be able to provide a Rift Scuttler there. Dub should be able to finish that one off. A whole lot of damage if you're by yourself and can just walk right up to it, and that one is going to
be durable as well. So Kiana's still going to need a lot of time. Lucian, obviously, is someone that she can eviscerate,
yep,
especially in the side lanes.
Onfleek will have the Elastic Slingshot once again. Sword gonna get licked. Thinking about eating back forward, but there's the Moonfall. Gravitant was there, I believe. But Onfleek now gonna get taken down into the passive. Goes Golden beforehand. Will buy some time. Supreme display of talent avoided by Root somehow. That was an incredible flash, as the Onslaught doesn't really do too much, and the Zac is going to be the first to fall down. Dove already flashing out of this fight, and Griffin should probably just cut their losses and disengage. As it looks like this outer turret in the mid lane is all but dead anyway, but no, Summit has to flash to get himself out of the way. Yukal won't find the Q as the Infernal Chain's not going to pull back Root after that success.
And Griffin winning this is actually super big for them. Had it gone the way of Sandbox, that really does a lot in helping, as small as it is, against the champions like Kiana. And so, Sandbox, in response to the Mountain Drake capture, they will capture mid-tier.
Moonfall. Sorry, the Moonshot. Moonfall's the other champion that's coming from the mid lane, and Sword's dead. Just gets chunked out. Burnham's going to secure it. Calibrum now attached as Yukal looking to try and get this one-for-one kill, but Dove gets the reset.
Hello, again, this is a pretty early Baron, even though you do have a Philios.
Well, Elastic Slingshot going to come down. This is 3 versus 5. The door is set up. The bullet time, gigantic! Onto everyone, as there's no passive left available for Onfleek. Now Joker is incredibly low. Sword looking for his way in and finds the first Q onto the tank from Griffin. Moonlight Vigil did absolutely nothing. Moonfall also absolutely nothing. Not sure what Dove was hoping to achieve in that moment. The culling. It's now Summit's turn to try and get something done, but the Baron is going to stop this from happening. Full unadulterated vision here as he does find them. A couple of people altered, and now immediately Dove has to go gold, and Onfleek used the Elastic Slingshot to get out, but Dove has been corralled, cornered, and destroyed. Root with Severum available, not exactly the optimal weapon, unless he can get really close to this. The flash in from Sword finds the Infernal Chains, and they will take down Joker. And Root just doesn't have the right...
And they still have yet, never mind actually, they're gonna turn their sights.
Yeah, throughout the first couple of weeks, I guess. Even though we're very early, Fleek was looking for a slingshot position, but you really do need vision before you can opt into any predator. They're looking to enclose onto Dove. As on Fleek, he's well and truly out of there. Joker might just have to be sacrificed. Can't buy any extra time, couldn't even find it. Griffin could still win. of course.
See a way for Sandbox to win this outside of some miracle engagement.
Yukal, there's the flash. He gets a three-man stun, and I have a feeling this might just be it. As Root has to flash to get out of there, but the Misfortune does so much damn damage. Dove wonders where everyone went, and Onfleek is running for the hills. Joker just walking up the mid lane, trying to extend this match as much as possible. Viper comes on over, Swords able to grab, and it's against their former rivals. The Griffin win rate in series over Sandbox continues to reign supreme.
This is just actually so surprising how this whole series just panned out. And I'm literally speechless.
Yeah.
Atlas, I have nothing.
And I want
to really
give the MVP to Tarzan, Yukal, and Viper for this. And just hadn't done a lot of winning for a really long time.
Yeah.
So congratulations to him, able to pick one up after 25 matches. My goodness.